So, just to tell you, I'm Francophone. So, English is not my first language. So, if sometimes I make mistakes, please don't kill me yet. And also know that I'm the one standing between you and the after party. So I'll try to make it quick so we can just all go. We are a team of 12 superheroes for now. And of course, we are already trying to get more people to join our team. But for now, we are just 12. We are specialized in e-commerce customization module. So for example, if you have a website and you want to get your customers to customize something online, we do that kind of stuff. Okay, so this is really trending right now, and for the next few years, there are already modules that allow people to purchase from their home, from same product to complex one, like a car from their home, a business card designed entirely online, and that kind of things. That's a bit what we do. And we sell exclusively on Code Canyon and Temporest. I'm not sure if some of you knows these websites. Yeah. So we are Elite Authors there. And yes, we've been doing that for 5 or 6 years, I think. Yeah, something about that. And we have 7,000 clients around the world. And for us, being a small country in Africa, yes, that's something that we are kind of proud of, and we used to brag about that. Yes. But it's not a lot yet, but it's something. And for now, we make more than $400,000, and we are looking to double that amount in this year and the next few months. So what I'm about to tell is how you can do something that like that and beat that number. Because when we talk to foreigners about what we do, what we achieve with the means we have, people say, you guys are strange. How can you manage that? How can you make it work with all the troubles we have? Okay? So, how did that start? I started alone. I was alone. And after my degree, I went working for a small company in my country, Benin. And after 1 year, my boss just fired me. Yes, it was kind of hard because I was like, I'm a rock star. I'm the best. And one day I come to work and the guy say, you have a letter waiting for you. I say, yes, probably a raise. And I say, what? And they gave me a letter and was like, you are free to go now. I say, what just happened? Because it was a hot note. And they said, okay, but why? Because when someone gives you a fine note and say, you are free to go now, it was, okay, but why? Unfortunately, I didn't have a chance to ask my employer that because he was not there. He just sent me a letter from his secretary and said, you are fine. I said, okay, no worries. Because where I come from, you are very proud. You don't beg and it's hard for us to cry. And I said, I wanted to cry. I said, okay. So I guess it's goodbye now. And okay, so I grabbed my stuff and just went home to cry. And after that, I was looking for money because I didn't have money. And I needed money in order to do stuff, get friends, chase girls, get married. So I needed money. So what do next? I joined a public company called Port Autonome de Cotonou. This is a port. When they get ships and handle everything there, a public company there in my country, a big one. And after the first day, I say, I can't work here. I just want to resign. And my friend will say, why? I say, when these kind of people get a request from, I was in the IT support service, when they get a request and say, yes, people, we need something like this, our computers are not working, we can't bill our client, they call us. And when they call our office, I had a boss who was just sitting there and say, yeah, we are coming, just wait. And we were like 10 people in the office. And this guy was just sitting down and saying, yeah, we are coming. But nobody was moving. And nobody was working. That was even worse because nobody was working. 10 people in the office, nobody was working, nobody was moving. And people were always calling. And I said, I can't work here because people don't just do anything. Just sit there waiting for the end of the month to get paid and just go home and do anything. I said, no, no way. But my mother was also working there. And I say, yeah, okay, let's make her happy for a while before quitting. I did that for a few months. Yes, about 6 months. And then they say, yeah, man, you are too good. Just work here because we need something, someone like you. And I say, no way. I will work, you get paid, you give me nothing, and then where you are good. I said, no, I resign. My contract was ready. It was all about signing my contract. I said, no way. Me, I just resign. I can't work in the office doing nothing all day and just get requests from customers or people say my fingers are not working. And people are just, yeah, we are coming. I said, no way. So I resigned. And my boss was, why? You have a good money? You have nothing to do? I said, yes. That's exactly the point. I have nothing to do, and I was just wanting my salary. No way. He didn't understand because that guy just spent around 10 years doing that, and it was good for him. But me, no, I was young, I had energy, so I had to spend it somewhere. So yeah, I just, bye my friend, it was good to meeting you, not really, but yeah, bye. And then I started freelancing on e-learning because yes, I quit, but yes, that's great. But money, where's money? Because when you have no job, you still need money, right? You need to go out, you need to make friends. So money. And then I found out about freelancing on e-learning. Who knows e-learning? You are too much knowing e-learning, okay? So I did e-learning and coders. And it was great because I was paying in dollars and I was spending in CFA. So yeah, money was good. Money was good, but it was not easy because on e-learning, you have to compete with Indians. I'm not sure if any of you knows about India. How you know about India? What do you know about them?
They are very good and they can offer rock bottom prices.
Wow, you know your stuff. That's Indians. I mean, these people are great. Let's not lie about that. They are great. And even if they don't know what they are, you can ask an Indian, yes, I need to do something like this. He say, yeah, I know, and I can do it. Don't worry about that. But that guy doesn't know what to do. And what does he do? He just look online, look for documentation how to achieve that. Because he knows that it's not impossible for him. So what is he looks? And he can achieve what he didn't do the first time. And at a cheaper rate. For example, me, I can charge something like, $14 or $20 or $15 or $5. Okay, $50. And that guy just come along and say, $5. Okay, how do you compete with that? That guy knows his stuff. He's 10 times cheaper than you. How do you compete? I found a way. I was, okay, $4 first. And I was getting customers because I was able to describe what I should do. So my customers were trusting me to get it done. And once I get them the first time, next time they offer me a job, I say $50. And customers don't want something else. They just want to be assured that it can be done. And you know the dictum, right? You don't change a winning team. Something about that. This is something you say in French. You don't, you know, if you have someone who is already achieving something, you don't go somewhere else. You just okay, my friend, yes, just meet and find an agreement. So first time was $4 because that guy was offering 5, but me is 50 now. And my customers were well, okay, and we go from there. And that's how I was able to learn around 5 customers the first 2 months, and then we escalated to 20 customers, all paying and recruiting revenue. But I was alone, and I needed to hire more people. What I did, I sent an ad in order to get more developers to work with me, because there is a limit on how much someone can achieve in a day. And it doesn't matter how good you are, there is a line you can cross. So you need other people to come and help you out. Okay, so I needed a team. So I started recruiting people, one by one. But this is Africa, because when you go to school and you try to hire people, they are not ready, but they want to get paid. So you give a part of your work to someone who is not able to deliver, but still want to get paid by the end of the month. How do you do? You say, okay, I will pay you, but I will train you to become better than me. So I guess just rest. When you earn your work, we will work. So that's what I did. And there are some people who were great, better than me the first day they started. And we built our team from there. After that, I met WordPress because it was good. You have to code something from scratch every day. And then I met WordPress. It was easy because you have to plug in, install themes, and start clicking. Click, 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 until the work is done and the website is complete. Yeah, sharp, sharp. It was good money too, because you don't have to go in code. Just click, 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 and it's complete. Work done, get paid. And since then, yes, I become lazy. Because, yes, it's WordPress, right? And now we are happily married, me and WordPress, of course. And 5 years now, and we have more than 7,000 kids who are our customers. Okay? Yes, 7,000 kids is not me only, because I can't do that. But 7,000 customers, paying, all paying. And yes, now let's not forget that we are in Africa. Internet is still an issue. Even though we have a top internet consumer in the world, internet is still expensive here. Even when you are paying customers, you can't get a working internet every day. For example, in my country, when it rains, you can't work. I don't know how they do that, but the fact is, when it rains, one day you wake up, it is raining. You can't walk. Just don't try, my friend. Don't try. Don't try. And even after that, internet was still expensive because we had 4 or 5 major internet providers in our country. We did all of them. All of them. I'm not lying. I'm not exaggerating. We did all of them. One day we start with that done. You have to install the connection. Install the antennas, install everything, buy a new router, everything. Okay, hoping it works, but it doesn't. And it's still costing a lot of money. We did 1, 2, 4, 5. And one day, we were calling our last provider when I heard, Orion guys, yeah, oh, no, we don't have enough money for you. I say, well, when you learn about us, yeah, no, we know you. We don't have enough bandwidth for you. Okay. Why? Oh no, we heard about you guys. You need a lot, and you complain a lot. We don't have it. We can't. And that's why. That brings me to my next question: what kind of bandwidth to expect when you work from Africa? Let's do some math, okay? Who are developers in the room? Web developers. Okay, who are simple users? Simple users, normal users, regular users who don't know anything about code. Okay, so yeah, we have more developers. That's strange because usually there are only two developers and all of the other guys are regular users. So I think that's congratulations for once. We are more developers than anyone in the room. So, when we work with customers, they are, for example, in the US or they are in Germany. You need to upload files on servers, right? Because a website is all about browsing files. You need to upload your files. You need to upload your pictures. If you have bad luck and your guy needs video, yeah, you just can't. But you should try, right? So, uploading files, uploading media, uploading websites, upgrading, doing a lot of stuff, that costs a lot of bandwidth. If you are alone, you can manage. Well, if you are 10, 12 people, who does that every day long? What do you do? Will you just buy a router per person? That will come up expensive, right? You can't. So, I found a way to make it work by implementing something called flexible work hours. We noticed that in the morning, people were able to make it work because there was not enough charge in the network. So in the morning, it was best. After 11 p.m., it was also good. So I let my guys work from home and they had internet at home. And then we were able to upload files. When someone has a lot of files to upload, he just does it at home. And we are looking, if we combine all our needs, we need something around 10 megabytes per second. And it is a dedicated line because when you are with a internet provider, they give you something we call shared bandwidth. That's just a lie. Because they can say, yes, you can upload up to 10 megabits. That's a big word, up. But they write it very small, you can't notice it. Up. So the first day you call to complain, they say, no, man, it's up to 10. So even if you are uploading in 1 megabit per second, you are still good, my friend. Just keep trying. So we need 10 megabits per second, a dedicated line, because we just want to be alone using that 10 megabits. And when you are uploading that kind of bandwidth, when you are using that kind of bandwidth, you just need people to be able to deliver, but you still will be hard to find. And we were spending at least 650K naira per month on internet. And even when you get paid, that's still a lot of money to give to someone in the internet. And when we go outside of Benin, our country, in somewhere like France or US, they spend something around $25 for internet, TV, phone line, everything in that $25. How can you compete with someone who is spending 650K naira when another person is just home and is spending $25? For me, I found that very frustrating because you don't get paid easily, and when you do, you give your money away to internet providers. So, one thing I learned about that is just to let it go. Yes, because you will just end up dead one morning for a heart attack, hypertension, or a lot of things. Just breathe, be zen, and let it go. And remember that there is not much you can do without internet. So you just have to give money and work. And when you work every day, you just remember that you have to pay that at the end of the month and work harder in order to get enough money to give them. Otherwise, when you tell your US customers that internet is slow, so I can't upload your 100, say, eh? Where are you based again? And I say, in Africa. Say, eh? You have internet there. Yeah, true story, I heard that. You have internet there. Oh yeah, we do. And we also have computers. We don't browse from phone line. You have a computer too. So yeah. Next one, I know that in Nigeria you know about that. Electricity issue. Yeah, because what's the point having computers when you just can't have electricity to charge them? Back in the day, there was not enough laptops. We were using desktops. And desktops don't have battery, right?
Yeah.
So when you are working, you are coding, you are saying, yeah, I'm good. No electricity. Ah, okay, no electricity. And what you do? You just wait to brave until the power comes back. And then someone started importing generators. And you say, yeah, I'm good now. I'm safe. But when generators are plugged in and are working, you get a lot of noise. How do you think? How can you conceive something, write down algorithm, and then still be able to code that when right at the door you say, then you just try or you buy earplugs. You have no choice, right? And when we use generators, we met someone who is not our friend, full scarcity. Because generators are working all day long, right? But they don't work for free too. You need to fuel them, you need to put fuel in them, right? Yeah, and then we met full scarcity. Because our country is very small. We don't produce fuel, oil, okay? So we are burning our fuel for use, guys. But then you, when you have fuel scarcity, what do we have? Right? We don't have any much to do, okay? We just say, okay, Nigeria had fuel scarcity. Let's try to move to England, France. But honestly, we don't have much to do. We just have to wait until you guys fix your fuel scarcity issue so we can get some fuel. Because that matter is out of our hands. So just be zen and wait until that issue goes away. How did we manage to harm that by politics? You see, we can spend a lot of time complaining, but when you elect a good president who is able to fix few things, I mean that's a lot. Because we were just suffering, waiting that someone one day found a better way to make electricity work in our country, and then we elected a new president. The first thing he did was fixing the electricity. And when he did that, I said, I don't care how much you embezzle, what you do, me, you are my guy forever. Because I don't care. You are my guy. Because he fixed electricity. And after that, we were able to work, really work, double our revenue, and then just work. Okay, so that's why politics matter. We can complain and say, I don't want to vote, I don't care who is elected. But once someone is elected and fix electricity, for me, that's good. And that's why when there are elections, people should vote.
Sorry. You have 10 more minutes.
Okay. Now, after that, we had to fix client issue, because when people heard that you are from Africa, they need, okay, but I'm not sure that you can support me. So there are a lot of techniques, because when people heard Africa, they don't love us. They don't. They think Africa is not good enough. We don't have enough for them to help them out. And that's strange, because when they heard that we are Africans, after using our plugin, they say, yeah, good job, guys. But only after they bought our product. The poor are free. When you give away something for free to customers, they won't complete first. Okay? They will just use it, try it, and make the best of it. And then they know that you have a solid product. That's why the free matters. Just think about giving something for free to users, something with limited features or limited in time. That goes a long way. And after we were giving for free, we just charged them after a few months or if they needed premium features. And that's how we managed to get a lot of customers, by giving something for free and getting them back a few months later. Live chat. When a customer is on your site, there is not much he can understand right away. So he needs to talk to the support team or the developer who implemented the tool he is checking. That's why a live chat is really important, because your potential customers can just come and say, yes, can your tool do this? Can your plugin do this? Can you have that kind of features? How do you handle this? How do you handle that? When you are able to talk to them, you got a new sale every time. Okay? So that is one of the things we did in order to get more customers. Fast, efficient support. When your customer has issue, you need to be fast. Be there, answer, and then get to another customer. That gives you a lot of reviews, good reviews. Okay? Our sales was just create a call. You can't do everything by yourself. So when you get a team, you create a core group of developers. These guys will help other people, train them, and get them to join your company. Okay, because you can't train everyone. You get 4 or 5 people, you train them first, and then they train your other guys for your product, to code, or anything. Push the core to the limit. You need to know your team limit. It's not about getting them to be lazy. It's about to get them to be better, the best at what they do. And once you reach that limit, you can know everyone what they can do, what they can't do. Never stop recruiting. I learned that the hard way, because we were at some point we were refusing customers because we could not handle them all. But when you have a lot of manpower, you never stop to recruit. So that means you basically have everyone in your team. So you just never stop recruiting and just get people. When someone is asking for a job, join your team, learn to work with your core, and then you never let them go. Okay, yeah, I'm ahead. Never let anyone to go, just like the mafia. When you join the mafia, you don't go out. Okay? So, be like them. They have very good corporate values. But don't be them. So, never allow anyone to go. You need to be able to understand your team. Because without your team, you are nothing. But once you are able to understand your team, and nobody will like to go work for someone else. Because they trust you, they can follow you anywhere. Okay? So you don't let them go. Try to understand why they are trying to find something better and be able to overbid. Code thieves, yeah, we got that too. We got a lot of code thieves, because when you are successful, people will just come and steal your code. That's a compliment, but not a good one, because that means you are good. But if they are better than you, they will just kill you with your own code. So we got that too, and we had to let them go. Why? Because someone stole our code, but he was in the US. We don't have jurisdiction there. You can sue someone from there. Even if you hire a lawyer online, you need to be able to pay that guy. And you can't just bribe someone in the US. That costs a lot of money. So instead of paying that kind of fees to someone who just stole your code, you need to be able to be better. But keep an eye on him. Otherwise, one day you just woke up and someone will tell you that, guys, you stole your plugin from that guy. Why? Because you were not checking up what he was up to. But once you keep an eye on the thief, you can know everything he's doing and then be able to do it better. And of course, prevent this from happening again. Because you can fight one thief, but you can't fight hundreds of them. So for developers, when you produce some code, you can just minify your source code so someone else can't just steal it. Okay? I think that's all. My friend there just told me that I don't have any time left, so. Question?
Okay, thank you.